Mr. Chairman, you also have a problem with the Hispanic vote. Univision conducted a poll, and 67% of Latinos would support President Barack Obama. Only 25% would support Mitt Romney. Now, among many Latinos, there's the perception that the Republican Party is becoming anti-immigrant. Why? Because Republicans approve an anti-immigrant law in Alabama, approve an anti-immigrant law in Arizona. Republicans are not supporting the DREAM Act. And for the first time since Ronald Reagan, you will have a Republican candidate who does not support immigration reform. So with these facts, how are you going to get the Hispanic vote?
Well, for one thing, let me, I hope, do I have time to
go
answer
ahead.
This?
Yes.
It's sort of a, it's obviously, it's a big question. Number one, I think that our messaging, whether you're, whatever your background, Hispanic or otherwise, but in regard to Hispanics and your question, the economy is a big issue. And the economy is an issue that I think, no matter what your background, is something that rings true to Hispanics. And that this president promised more jobs, less unemployment, better record on spending and debt. And if you look at the polling that just came out the other day from Washington Post as well, it shows that a majority of Hispanics don't agree that we're on the right track in this country.
I understand, but the question has to do with the perception that many Latinos feel that the Republican Party is anti-immigrant.
And I think the difference is that top-line messaging is better. Number two, our messengers are better. I mean, if you look at what party, Republican or Democrat, who's having the success with Hispanic candidates across this country? You look at Marco Rubio, Luis Sandoval, Susana Martinez, Luis Fortunio in Puerto Rico. Our messengers are better. But our strategy has to be on the ground, Jorge. I mean, my job as chairman of this party has to be connecting the dots on the ground. I,